5 seconds to go. The appellant who lost the Lok Sabha election filed an election petition challenging the election of the respondent returned candidate primarily on the allegations that the respondent had made communal appeals to the electorate and prayed that the election of the respondent be declared as void under sections 101B and 101D of the Representation of the People Act 1951, and the petitioner be declared as elected in terms of section 101B of the Act. In support of his allegations, he filed a VHS cassette said to have contained the speeches made by the respondent. The election tribunal dismissed the election petition, holding that the election petitioner had failed to prove the allegations as he did not produce any evidence to show that the VHS cassette filed by him was the true reproduction of the original speeches made by the respondent. The tribunal also did not accept the plea of the election petitioner that the cassette was obtained from the Election Commission and was a public document, and its mere production was sufficient, and no further evidence was required to be adduced to prove as to how the said cassette was obtained by him. Aggrieved, the petitioner filed the appeal. The questions for consideration before the court were whether the finding by the tribunal that in the absence of any evidence to show that the VHS cassette was obtained by the appellant from the Election Commission, the cassette placed on record by the appellant could not be treated as a public document is perverse, and whether a mere production of an audio cassette, assuming that the same is a certified copy issued by the Election Commission, is per se conclusive of the fact that what is contained in the cassette is the true and correct recording of the speech allegedly delivered by the respondent or his agent. Dismissing the appeal, the court held the tribunal has rightly held that in the absence of any cogent evidence regarding the source and the manner of its acquisition, the authenticity of the cassette was not proved, and it could not be read in evidence despite the fact that the cassette is a public document. No relevant material was brought to notice of the court which would impel it to hold that the finding by the tribunal is perverse, warranting interference. A charge of corrupt practice envisaged by the Representation of the People Act 1951 is equated with a criminal charge, and therefore standard of proof therefore would not be preponderance of probabilities as in a civil action, but proof beyond reasonable doubt as in a criminal trial. If a stringent test of proof is not applied, a serious prejudice is likely to be caused to the successful candidate, whose election would not only be set aside, but he may also incur disqualification to contest an election for a certain period, adversely affecting his political career. Thus, a heavy onus lies on the election petitioner to prove the charge of corrupt practice in the same way एज अ क्रिमिनल चार्ज इज प्रूव्ड।